cancer. But God said, don't focus on the people, focus on me. Those people are about to run past you and see what God is doing in your life.
Yeah.
God said, I'm about to give you a testimony. You can't have a testimony without a test.
There you go.
You can't spell testimony without a test. Come on here. God said, you're going to come out of this, and you're going to come out strong. Hallelujah. Prophesy to your neighbor and tell him,
my blessing
is on the way. Be patient with me. God is not through with me yet. But when he gets through with me,
I shall
come forth as pure gold. Run here signifies an announcement of a divine revelation. God said, I'm about to give them something to talk about.
Well,
woo, God, I thank you. I'm about to give them something that's going to make them shake their head at what I have done in your life.
Yeah.
Come on, God said, hallelujah, don't you give up on me. Don't you focus on what is happening around you, but know that I'm the God. I'm the same yesterday, I'm the same today, and I'm the same forever.
Yes, Lord. Well.
He said, declaring now, because it's about to manifest later. Hallelujah. You got to write it. You got to write it. You got to speak it. Amen. Even though you don't see it.
Amen.
Folk don't know what you're believing God for because you're keeping it to yourself. Because you said, I don't want to say nothing because if it don't happen, they're going to call me a liar. Hallelujah. He says, out of your mouth flows blessings. Come on here. Come on. You speak, have not, because you speak not. Speak those things that be not as though they already are.
Yeah.
Amen.
Mm-hmm.
Amen.
Say so.
Write it. Tell it. So that when it does happen, they can know that your God did it.
Yeah.
Thank you, Father.
Thank you, God.
They will look at your circumstances and know there is no way, no how, this should have happened this way.
Well.
And when they ask you how, you say, God did it. Hallelujah. He specializes in things that seem impossible. And he will do what no other power, nothing but the Holy Ghost power can do.
Yes.
Go ahead.
I love that song. Have you any rivers that seem uncrossable? Have you any mountains that you can't tunnel through? God specializes.
Yes, he does.
Ooh, I'm getting happy by myself in things that seem impossible.
Yes.
And he will do
what
no other power can do.
Yes, hallelujah.
Not only must you watch.
Yeah.
Not only must you write.
Yes.
But number three, you gotta wait. Somebody say wait.
Wait.
Habakkuk 2:3 says, but these things I plan for you, they're not gonna happen right away.
Mm-hmm.
Don't you love how honest God is?
Mm-hmm.
He didn't mislead you.
Mm-hmm.
Hallelujah, like some folk do.
Mm-hmm.
He said, it ain't happening right away.
Not right away.
In fact, it's gonna seem slow.
Mm-hmm.
It's gonna seem like it's taking forever. Everybody else around you seem like they just getting blessed. Come on here, they naming it and claiming it, they blabbing it and grabbing it. Hallelujah, but yours just seem to be taking forever. Hallelujah, but the good food gets cooked slow. You can stick a big turkey in the microwave if you want to. Hey, God, I thank you.
It ain't gonna get
hallelujah. Done. I know you like the deep fried turkey. Hallelujah. But I like my stuff to cook slow. Make sure the inside.
Yeah,
come on.
Come on here. It's ready. He said it's going to seem slow, but he says wait patiently.
Yeah.
For it will surely take place.
Yeah.
He says it's going to seem slow. It's going to seem slow. It's going to be slow. It's going to be steady. It's going to be sure.
Mm-hmm.
Hallelujah. But he said the vision will be fulfilled, mm-hmm. Apostle.
Yes, it will.
Glory to God.
It will be fulfilled.
Mm-hmm.
It's coming.
Mm-hmm.
That should be enough faith for us to begin to speak it. Hallelujah. It should be enough for us.
Mm-hmm.
He says this prophecy in verse 3 has reference to the last days in which the judgment would fall on the world.
Mm-hmm.
The meaning being that when sin and rebellion has run their course, the final judgment will fall on the world.
Mm.
You think they're getting away. They think they're getting away. But there's going to be a day,
mm-hmm.
where we all going to stand before God.
Yeah.
Hallelujah. Habakkuk nor us should be upset or perplexed when we see things not going as we think they should.
Mm-hmm.
This doesn't mean that God approves of what's happening. Amen. But in his own time, God's going to settle the account. Somebody say, settle the account.
Settle the account.
And this was the answer that God gave to Habakkuk.
Mm-hmm.
And it's applicable to us. We've got to wait until God finishes the work,
mm-hmm.
and let the process run its course. Then our blessing is going to be revealed.
Mm-hmm.
Tell somebody, in the meantime. In between time, you gotta wait. You can't wait angrily. You can't wait upset. You can't get frustrated. You gotta wait for the smooth operator. Hallelujah, to do his job. He knows how to work it out. He doesn't need your advice. He doesn't need your encouragement. Hallelujah, all he wants is for you to trust him. He's working on something that the naked eye can't see. He's doing some behind the scene work. Hallelujah. You can't see him, but that doesn't mean he's not working. Hallelujah. I remember walking down the street and there was a big hole in the street and there was a sign posted there saying men at work. I looked up in the trees, I didn't see no men. I looked out in the hole, I really couldn't see no men.
Yeah.
And God said to me, just because you don't see them working,
yeah.
doesn't mean they're not at work. They're way down under the ground. Come on here, digging up roots and doing some things to help you, amen, on the top. Hey, God, I thank you. And I stopped by to tell you today that God is working on some things that your naked eye can't see. Eyes haven't seen and ears haven't heard, and neither has it entered the hearts of men, the great things God has in store for you. But we stopped right there. But he said, but he has revealed it to those who will lay before him prostrate and who will listen and wait to hear what he has to say. God said, I'm preparing you for something you can't handle right now.
Yeah.
I'm making you ready. Hallelujah. You can't rush me. Don't push me. Don't try to get in front of me. He says, I'm working on it. You just be patient. Isaiah 40:31 said it like this, but they that wait upon the Lord shall renew their strength. They shall mount up with wings as eagles. They shall run and not be weary. They shall walk and not faint. Wait, I say, on the Lord. Wait on him. The problem we have in the church is because we don't understand that God gives three answers throughout your life. In any number of situations.
Yeah.
Number one, God will often say yes when you are praying about something. We love a yes, Pastor. We love when God says yes. We know you got a yes because you shout around the church. We know you got a yes because you came to church. Come on here. We know when you got a yes because you got a big smile on your face. We know when you got a yes because you paid your real tithes. We know when you got a yes. Yes makes us feel God good. Yes makes us believe God really loves us. Yes.
Well, yes.
Makes us feel like we are walking in a good relationship with God. I love a yes. Tell somebody, I love a yes from God. But sometimes God will say no.
Well,
you know the folk that gotta know. They sit way in the back of the church. You know the folk that gotta know. That face got a big frown. You know the folk that gotta know. They look sad. They come on here. They look down. They low down. Come on here. You know the folk that gotta know. Pastor, I can't make it today. I got to run in my pantyhose. Bishop, I can't make it today. My dog ran over my foot. Bishop, you know when you got to know.
That's good.
I love it, yes.
That is good.
Yeah. But in my growing up, Travis and God, I learned how to thank God for the no's.
That's right.
How about myself right here? I learned how to thank God for the no's. Mm-hmm. No means I know better than you.
Thank you.
I'm about to help somebody over here. No means that's not the one for you. Hey, hallelujah. No means if you go down that road, you on your own. Wanted to marry this man, my God, so much. Amen. But God told me no. You know why he told me no? Because he had a tall, dark, handsome Bishop David William Evans waiting on me. Somebody say, thank God for no.
Yeah.
Hallelujah. I'm trying to help you. Hallelujah. If I had gone to my class reunion, I might have seen that young man that I really wanted to marry, Brother Cameron. He probably wouldn't have had no teeth. Oh, God, would have been limping.
Yes.
Mama said, don't ask. ask me no questions when I give you direction. You just go do it.
Right.
Hallelujah. God knows